If my mother went through menopause at an early age, does that mean that I will also? Could I lose my fertility when I am younger? As a fertility specialist, these are questions that I get often. Hi, I'm Dr. Randy Morris M.D. I am a board-certified reproductive endocrinologist. This is what most people call a fertility specialist. Today on Infertility TV, I am going to discuss how the function of your ovaries is affected by genetics and how it runs in families. I am filming this episode here at the annual meeting of the American Society for Reproductive Medicine. In order to understand fertility and menopause, you first need to understand a little about how eggs form in the ovaries. Eggs first appear in the ovaries when the fetus is about 11 to 12 weeks old. The number of eggs in the ovaries increases rapidly until about 28 weeks. At that point, new egg production stops and the existing eggs start degenerating. This process of degeneration continues after birth. As a result, the number of eggs remaining in the ovaries is constantly declining. The number of eggs that remain in the ovaries is referred to as ovarian reserve. Fertility doctors try to measure ovarian reserve in a number of different ways. First, there are blood tests. AMH, which comes from the ovaries, is higher when there is a healthy reserve of eggs and decreases as the reserve declines. FSH, which comes from the pituitary gland, is the opposite of AMH. Low levels are seen in people with good ovarian reserve, and high levels occur when reserve is poor. Ultrasound can also be used to estimate reserve. Each egg in the ovary is surrounded by a group of cells. This is called a follicle. During maturation, some fluid is produced in the follicle, which can be seen with ultrasound. By counting the number of follicles that are visible at the beginning of your period, doctors can get an estimate of ovarian reserve. If they see more follicles, then your reserve is better. Menopause, or ovarian failure, occurs when the reserve of eggs has been depleted. The average age for menopause is 50. Some women, however, will see their supply of eggs drop more rapidly. If ovarian failure occurs before the age of 40, we call it premature ovarian failure. Prior to complete ovarian failure, women may experience less severe stages. So there is a spectrum of ovarian function. You may hear doctors talk about decreased ovarian reserve or premature ovarian insufficiency. Women who have decreased reserve may experience infertility, lower pregnancy rates with fertility treatments, irregular periods, and sometimes their periods will stop coming. What causes some women to have premature decline in the function of their ovaries? There are a number of causes, but genetics is probably the most important. Genes control every stage of the production and development of eggs and how long they stay around. Mutations and variations in the genes will result in some women experiencing a lowering of their reserve at an earlier age. Scientists have discovered hundreds of these genes so far, but more are being discovered all the time. Since genetic mutations and variations are inherited, that means it is possible for these problems to run in families. How common is this? Recently, researchers conducted a study in the state of Utah. Utah has a database that links the medical information from millions of people with their family ancestry. In fact, over 2 million people in the database have at least 3 generations of information available. First, they looked at people with a diagnosis of premature ovarian insufficiency, or POI, which they defined as women under the age of 40 with an FSH over 20 or an AMH less than 0.08. They identified about 400 individuals with POI who had at least 3 generations of ancestry information in the database. These 400 individuals had 2,132 first-degree relatives, over 5,000 second-degree relatives, and over 10,000 third-degree relatives in the database. What did they find? About 6% of the women with POI had a relative with POI also. This is way more than would be expected in a group of women. Overall, premature ovarian insufficiency is found in less than 1% of women. Close relatives were more likely to be affected. For example, a first-degree relative relative, such as a daughter or a sister, was over 18 times more likely to have ovarian insufficiency. A second-degree relative, such as a granddaughter, aunt, or niece, was over 4 times more likely to have POI. A third-degree relative, such as a great-granddaughter or cousin, was still over 2.5 times more likely to have POI. What does all of this mean? If you have a relative with ovarian insufficiency, you are at greater risk to have it yourself. The closer the relative, the greater the risk. So yes, if your mother went through menopause at an early age, you have a higher chance that you could too. If you have ovarian insufficiency, there is a greater chance that your sisters or daughters or their children might develop it as well. At the current time, there is no known method to prevent this decline in ovarian function. But with this information, people may want to make different decisions, such as trying to conceive children at an earlier age, or maybe freezing eggs or embryos before the problem becomes too severe. Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. Don't miss any episodes. You can also check us out on our website, ivf1.com, where you can become a patient.